Hi, Jim Rohmer, Dr. Weather, your exclusive bar chart report. We'll be talking about these incredible heat domes and all the commodities around the world. It's not La Nina, folks. It's not El Nino, folks. It is the warming oceans, mostly, I believe, because of climate change. We're going to be talking about all this, which markets are being affected, one dome in the United States, one in Europe, one in Asia. Look at this, one after another, record heat. For example, Phoenix, Arizona had almost every day above 100 degrees. Hasn't happened in 5,000 years. They've closed the Acropolis in Greece because of all the record warm weather. And obviously, there's still some drought concerns and back and forth weather maps with the corn and soybean market. Let's get right to it. First of all, about 3 to 4 weeks ago, I was predicting these rains for the Corn Belt. Yes, it hasn't broken the drought completely. Still about 35 to 40% of the Midwest is in a drought situation. But in green and blue over the last 3 weeks, 70% of the Corn Belt, anywhere from 2 to 5 inches of rain, normal to slightly above normal rainfall. That's helped crop prospects improve somewhat. But then we had fireworks with these domes developing this week and a big move up in corn and beans early on in the week, as well as, of course, the situation with Russia. The bombing, the explosions, the canceling of exports, craziness in all these markets right now. So here's the jet stream pattern now going into the end of July and early August. Typically, if you look at this, that red blob you see over the Arctic Circle tends to bring cool fronts south. One reason why 3 or 4 weeks ago during most El Ninos, if you have that block as well over the Arctic Circle, I predicted an easing in certain places somewhat of this drought, except for the far northwest Corn Belt in Canada that's in a severe drought right now. That's happened, but the corn and bean estimates but the USDA are probably too high, maybe around 170, 171 bushels per acre for corn now, maybe 50 for beans. And that's one of the reasons why the markets come back, an overreaction to a bearish USDA crop report on July 11th. Look at this situation, though, coming into the end of July, early August. Yes, some real heat next week, hundreds in parts of the Corn Belt, but also that red ridge over the Arctic still forcing down some cold fronts, so scattered rains early to mid next week in parts of Iowa, maybe Nebraska once again. And then by early August, a little bit of a pattern change, very, very complicated because not all areas are seeing complete hot, dry weather. That's why the grain market has been very, very volatile, okay? The real situation, of course, has been in Canada, where I haven't seen much relief for drought. There's going to be some rains next week. And we've had an explosion in canola prices and oats over the last few weeks. Look at this. Canola broke out about 3 or 4 weeks ago. The whole biodiesel market is just soaring right now. Soybean oil as well. Great demand. Concerns about the Russian situation. Of course, this drought over in Canada. Look at these record high temperatures. I mean, 52 degrees, 115 degrees in parts of China. My goodness, that's going to actually affect the cotton crop, even though most of the crop is irrigated. Incredible, coast to coast, country to country, record heat all over the world right now. And you can see that drought, of course, in Canada in dark red. So this is a situation typically with El Nino, not all, but most you have in blue, abnormal, the cool summer. Well, folks, the oceans are warming up at an incredibly rapid rate. I mentioned this about a week or so ago, 97 degrees. Are you kidding me? You don't believe in a warming planet? It's not because of El Nino, folks. It's because, in my view, of climate change. Solar cycles is not doing this. El Nino is not doing this. It's the warming oceans, okay? Talk to most scientists around the world, and you will understand a little bit better the real truth about this. So all this record heat is creating droughts again and heat in Texas. Situations over in much of China that could jeopardize the cotton crop. This is one of our recommendations, our weather spider that traders, farmers all over the world actually use. This was about 2 or 3 weeks ago. We caught the beginning of this bull market in cotton. We have a anti-herd mentality, which suggests the commitment of traders, economic fundamentals, a variety of other factors like global crop conditions, weather. We did this for all commodities in our Weather Wealth newsletter. And make sure you go to my website and download a free issue about this heat dome and how it's affecting the commodity markets. I'm going to give you a free issue of Weather Wealth this week. You'll see a lot of the ideas I've had with these spiders. I'm not going to recommend all the trades I've given to my clients over the last few weeks. Many of them have been profitable, though, of course, past performance is not indicative of future results. But make sure you go to my link here today and you download a free issue of Weather Wealth and understand what's going on with these incredible domes around the world. What else is going on? It's been so warm, it's actually creating flooding, heavy rains in parts of the Ivory Coast, cocoa growing areas. Usually you want dry weather this time of the year for cocoa in West Africa. As the crop needs to dry out, you see there in red some stress. That's also helped cocoa as well. Now, with sugar, another market we're watching, Thailand's drought is getting really, really bad. That's mainly because of El Nino. But with all this rain coming into the main sugar areas of India, if that rain continues through August and September, then India could actually have a relatively big sugar crop. We'll be watching that very closely for Weather Wealth clients. You also have good weather in Brazil. So even though sugar is going up because the Brazil real is breaking out and we have a weaker dollar, overall, the weather in two of three of the most important countries, India and also Brazil, is relatively bearish. Will that change? How do you trade everything from natural gas, which we advised clients to buy about a week ago because of this extreme heat in the United States, to cocoa, sugar, grains? Subscribe to a two-week free trial period of the Weather Wealth and download a free issue this week. Enjoy and have a very nice weekend. Thank you.